You're listening to Tim Bulkeley's 5-Minute Bible, beginning to read Isaiah. Isaiah is such a difficult book to read. It's huge, 66 chapters, and the chapters themselves are immensely varied, and even within many of the chapters there are lots and lots of little speeches and changes of topic. And then there's the problem that in scholarly circles at least, the book is presumed often to come in three parts, chapters 1 to 39, chapters 40 to 55 and chapters 56 to 66, and of course some scholars divide it into hugely more parts, and these parts are seen as being composed by different people, and that leads many ordinary readers to wonder whether this hacking up of the book diminishes Isaiah the prophet. That's a question we'll have to come back to in another podcast. In this one, keep at the back of your mind the question of why scholars divide the book up that way. But first, what's in the book? How's it organized? It's a huge book, and it comes in sections, though these aren't marked off in the manuscripts. But as we read the book, we can begin to spot chunks of material that is related to itself and not related to the bits around it. The first such big chunk is chapters 1 to 12. Here we've got lots of short speeches, often about justice for the poor and the weak. We've speeches mainly to the king about the Syro-Ephraimite crisis, and these lead to hope for a remnant that will be faithful and blessed, unlike Judah in the current day. Within this, chapter 6 stands in the middle, separating and joining what are fairly obviously two distinct halves of the material in 1 to 5 and in 7 to 12. Then in chapters 13 to 23 we've got a series of speeches against foreign nations, including though Judah itself near the end, so a series of speeches against nations. The speech against Judah is in chapter 22. Chapters 24 to 27 have an eschatological focus and are quite difficult to place in terms of their historical setting, and difficult to understand too because of their elusive eschatological language. But these chapters stick together and they stand out from the rest of the book as different. Then in chapters 28 to 35 we have a collection of material that stands out mainly because the blocks at either end of it in 24 to 27 and in 36 to 39 are so clearly blocks that are different, but also because in 28 to 35 we have a collection of woe to speeches dotted through the chapters, and the historical setting of all of the material in these chapters seems to run from the fall of the northern kingdom Israel to the Assyrian crisis in 701, and this historical setting and the collection of woe to speeches gives a sense of unity to these chapters. Then in chapters 36 to 39 we get a collection of narratives that are almost the same, and scholars have to debate which is copying which, they're so close, to the material in 2 Kings 18 to 20, and all of it's about the Assyrian crisis of 701. Then in chapters 40 to 55 we have material that stands out from what's gone before in tone, and the very opening words set this with the instruction to a prophet to proclaim comfort. The material in the first part of the book has not been comfortable at all. Theological emphasis. This material is encouraging people to trust that God will do good for them, rather than warning them that God is going to punish them. And in style, we've got here long connected poems, so connected that it's quite difficult sometimes to spot where one poem ends and the next begins, rather than short speeches. And all of this material seems to be talking to, and perhaps, though some scholars disagree, from the situation of exile in Babylon. Finally, chapters 56 to 66 are again more varied, though they're very like chapters 40 to 55 in style, but their different interests seem to suggest the Persian period, when Judahites were once again in control of their own destiny, at least to an extent, in the land, and there was no longer the same strong sense of exile. So we have this book that falls into a number of parts, but within those parts there are three main blocks of material by the apparent historical setting of their interests. Big and complicated, and we need to come back to this topic more to understand what's going on. Bye for now.